We will start our adjustments from PUBG in game graphics settings. And then we will adjust some system settings as well. And after that, I will show you how you can step up the overall performance of your device. If you haven't watched my previous video on how to download and install Bluestacks on your PC, then please watch it first. So, let's begin without any delay. First of all, open PUBG and go to settings. I'll make a different video for this gameplay adjustment, but for this tutorial, let's go to graphics settings. I will adjust the settings of combat only, because this tutorial is going to be very long. And you can copy the combat settings and adjust the same settings to lobby as well. First of all, we have graphics settings. Normally, it's good to lower up to the bottom, but let's keep it balanced. Because the combination of balanced graphics and medium frame rate gives more details while gaming. Set the style to classic, as it will be easy to track enemies when combined with medium frame rate. Turn anti-aliasing off. It will make the texture smooth and we don't want the smoothness because the movement will be blurry and less visible. Leave the colorblind mode. Disable shadows as well because the shadows option fit better with higher gameplay settings. Increase brightness up to 110 to clearly see the texture to track movements. Once you set all these settings, close the settings menu from PUBG. Now close the game as well. After the in-game settings, let's move to Bluestacks settings. First of all, access the settings menu from this settings icon located at the bottom right corner of Bluestacks. Inside settings, we have a lot of options available, but we are going to change 4 different settings only. The first setting we are changing is performance. Inside performance, choose high, and if your PC doesn't have 4 cores like mine, then don't worry, choose the higher one. Next, choose memory to high as well, and Bluestacks will automatically allocate a usable amount itself. And just like performance, you can change the amount from custom as well, which will give you a higher number. Inside performance mode, choose higher performance. Now, on FPS, lower it up to 30 FPS. If your device can handle more FPS, then we will change it after, but for now, set it to 30. Now, click on Save and Restart to save changes. Let's move to the Display tab. Choose a lower resolution for best performance and frame rate. I will choose 1280 by 720. If my gameplay lags, then I'll lower it to 960 by 540. I will set the DPI to low, which is 160 DPI. Now, click on Save and Restart to save changes. Now, moving towards Graphics Engine mode, choose Performance. The graphics renderer is a bit tricky, so leave it as default for now. And after changing all the settings, if your device still lags, you can change graphics renderer to DirectX as well. Because some graphics renderers are more compatible with DirectX and some with OpenGL. On the interface renderer, choose software, because the software renderer is faster than others. The ASTC texture stands for Adaptive Scalable Texture Compression. Keep it disabled for good. Now, click on Save and Restart to save changes. Inside Device Settings, choose your device profile to ASUS ROG 2 because the ASUS ROG 2 is the best gaming smartphone in the market right now. Now, click on Save Changes. These are the settings of Bluestacks only. Now, we are going to change settings from our system. The first thing we have to do is change default graphics settings and set it to best performance. To do so, go to Start and search for settings. Inside settings, choose Display. Then scroll down and select Graphics. Now, under Custom Options for the App section, choose Desktop App. Then click Browse. Now, follow me carefully. Navigate to your C drive. Then click on Program Files. After that, open the Bluestacks_NXT folder. Now, scroll down and select SD Player. The SD Player application is actually the Bluestacks emulator. Then click on Add. After that, click on Bluestacks and select Options. Inside the pop-up, choose High Performance and click Save. Now, close the settings. After this, let's change Power option to Performance mode. So, go to Start and search for the Control Panel. Select Hardware and Sounds. Go to Power options. Now, you might have an option called Performance. Choose it. And if you want to create your own power plan, click on Create a Power Plan from the left hand side. Then select High Performance. Under the Name section, write High Performance and click Next. Finally, click on Create. Now, after setting the High Performance Power Plan, close the Control Panel. Now, let's enable Game Mode. Go to Start and search for Settings. Open Settings. Go to Gaming and click on Game Mode. Then enable Game Mode from here. Finally, the most important setting we have to set is Priority. Press Ctrl Shift and Escape at once and Task Manager will open up. From there, go to the Details tab. Go to Bluestacks or SD Player and right-click on it. Hover over Set Priority and select Priority to High. Do this just before playing a game. If you do this at first, then your system will lag. This setting will utilize your PC's resources mostly to Bluestacks. And you have to do this process every time before you play PUBG. These are the major settings you have to change in order to get more FPS and improve performance. In the upcoming videos, I'll find new tricks and methods to improve performance. Till then, stay tuned. I hope this tutorial was helpful for you. If it works, let me know either by hitting the like button or even by writing a comment. Plus, let's hit the target of 10 likes in this video. Finally, if you like this tutorial, then subscribe to my channel for more useful videos like this. And this much for today, guys. See you in the next video.